thing happened in the insurance sector. But I think it's a very good product of protection, safety, tax exemption, savings. You have everything in one product. And I hope that the Indian citizens understand, the younger generation understands, that you should take a policy because it protects your family, it gives you a savings interest, and it gives you a certain amount of interest, and it gives you tax benefit.
Parikh,
sir,
what is the quick reaction from you on the Moody's upgrade as well? How do you see that pan out for the banks and for the country?
I think it's taken a long time for Moody's to give India upgrade in its rating. I've always felt that India's rating was far below what it should be, particularly during the last 2-3 years, the number of reforms the government has undertaken. It's a little too late. We should have got it much earlier. And again, one notch may be okay, but then they've put Baa2, but they've not put positive, they've put stable. If you see the steps government has taken, particularly in the last year and a half, they have been all positive for the economy. I have in my life not seen such strong macro fundamentals that we are today. But somehow the rating agencies look at it differently. I think the bank recapitalization made them convinced that India is on a reform path, and we mean business, and we are going to tackle NPAs, and we are going to do with the bankruptcy code also. So some of these steps have helped in India's upgrade.
Sir, you have said about the macro fundamentals, but it's not...
I don't think it is high at all. Our reserves are, even if you take the foreign debt, there are many countries where foreign debt is very high. Our foreign debt is nothing at all. Our reserves are 400 billion, foreign debt is 450, 460 billion. But the foreign debt, 50-60% of the foreign debt is long-term, 20-30 years, IDA, JICA money, World Bank, ADB. So it's very long-term.
So you have said macro fundamentals, but the macro data is not reflected in macro data. Look at GDP data, IIP data, inflation data, or export data.
I don't agree with that. Ek quarter 5.7 GDP growth aaya, that was due to the introduction of GST. जो कोई भी कंपनी में आप देखिए, 3 महीने के बदले 2.5 month का सेल हुआ था. लास्ट 15 days सेल्स हैड स्टॉप बिकॉज डी स्टॉकिंग वॉज टेकिंग. ऑल द डीलर्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर वॉज सेलिंग एग्जिस्टिंग स्टॉक बिकॉज अ न्यू टैक्स रिजीम वॉज कमिंग. सो इट वॉज नॉट अ प्रॉपर 3 month पीरियड. दिस क्वार्टर, द सेकेंड क्वार्टर, द GDP ग्रोथ इट हैज कम अप 6.6. सो आई डोंट थिंक यू शुड लुक एट वन क्वार्टर, दैट वॉज एन एबरेशन.
Mr. Parikh, it's a very crowded insurance market. You've seen a lot of insurance paper hit in the capital market recently. Two questions. Firstly, what makes HDFC standardized stand out? And secondly, just taking on from the Moody's update which has come in earlier today, is it a validation of the government's reform process, which perhaps is a backward because of criticism on GST and demonetization?
I think where we stand out, Every chairman of every company feels that they are better than the others. So it's not right for me to criticize others and say we are the best. But you know, if you see the ROE of HDFC Life is much better. The ULIP is a lesser proportion than some of our other peers. The ULIP percentage is lower. Our persistent ratio is good. And the brand name is there. And we, as you heard, this is the first issue in 22 years. We have not entered the market in 22 years. And all the companies that are listed, be it HDFC or bank or group, have done exceptionally well over the last 2-3 decades. So this is one more in the stable of HDFC. And hopefully we will do in the first quarter sometimes asset management company.
Mr.
Bali,
sir, the question on Moody's, sir. Is there a redemption of the government's reform agenda?
It is not a redemption, you can't say. Moody's and S&P really look at macro numbers, and they talk to number of people, and they come to their own decision. Again, we don't know who takes the final decision. But as they saw and as they noticed the seriousness of the government to carry on with reforms, carry on with difficult reforms, GST took 10 years to implement, to start. It was a combination of 17 taxes, state and central. It's a hugely complex exercise. But Mr. Jaitley was able to pull it through. Fine, there may be some teething problems, and therefore you have a GST council. And the GST council is very proactive and listening to every customer, every client, every industry to say if any injustice has been done to correct it. Again, they have very clearly said in a period of time we will have two rates and not four. So, you know, the seriousness of the government in doing not incremental reforms, in big reforms, transformational reforms, is what was noticed by these ratings.
Sir, one at a time.
One at a time.
13 years
from
getting profitable in this industry, what do you think are the significant challenges going ahead?
No, after 13, 14, 15, 16, we've made profits. We've increased dividends. So now we are on a growth path.
But what are the challenges that the insurance sector is facing?
Sorry?
The
challenges insurance sector is facing is that the distributors are taking a fair amount of money. And we have to work with the distributors to see how we can rationalize that. And the other challenge is, as I mentioned, insurance is never bought, it has to be sold. You need a lot of effort, particularly medical test, check. Very few people want to go through medical check, and it's a hassle. And so, you know, it is a complex product, but the penetration levels are so low, it is 2% or so. So there's only one way to go. If you see our neighboring countries, also penetration levels are 6 and 7%.
Sir, just to take the point of moving forward, sir, they've
also said that the GDP growth for the current quarter will be 6.7 and for the next quarter is estimated at 7.5. According to you, what would it take, what would be the incremental steps that would be required to take it to two digits, double digit growth, according to you, from the government?
Now you are asking a very long question. I can't answer in 1 minute. You know there are various things which are work in process. Land reforms, that's work in labor reform, that's work in progress. So like that, there are many reforms that are work in progress. Infrastructure build takes time. Government has put huge effort in road building. And you see, the roads can't be built overnight. Affordable housing, I have not seen a single industry in India which is tax-free. Affordable housing builders, developers who build small homes, affordable homes, don't have to pay tax. It's a huge incentive, it's a huge advantage for developers. I see large builders who are making luxury homes now switching to affordable homes. Because who doesn't want, everyone wants to save taxes. So, you know, the emphasis the government has given on affordable housing is enormous. That also creates jobs, skilled and unskilled. That also kickstarts your economy, cement and steel, building material. And you know, you need, there's a huge shortage of housing, affordable homes.
Mr.
Parekh,
you said you wanted to sell more of endowment products, but LIC still owns the lion's share there. So how do you plan to kind of move, or the unit share is the lowest, but how do you kind of plan to move the unit share
down? We have to have better distributors, better agents who can convince people that endowment policy is the right thing for them. And LIC is a behemoth. But even then, if you see the total premium, now more or less it's 55-45. So the private sector has made a dent in the last decade to reduce LIC's share.
Sir, policy
Reserve Bank policy, main baat nahi kar sakta.
Correct.
It has not at all impacted. RERA has impacted because RERA, the government the builders have to get their house in order first because every project has to be shown on the net, funding, who gave them funding, all the approvals, how many flats have been sold, how many are yet to be sold. So each project have to have a separate thing. They can't transfer money from one to the other and can't take money from here and buy land somewhere. So it brings a lot of discipline. So it takes time for the developers to get used to it. But that's one of the best things that has happened in real estate, because now it's totally transparent.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I mentioned next quarter.